All right, sorry about that, guys. Dustin not being in tonight, we apparently had a bit of a glitch, so...
If you'd like to keep us on the air, purchase a support package, so stuff like that doesn't happen again.
We'll get our own satellite upload system, and you'll be able to beam us. In the event of a nuclear holocaust, we will be able to broadcast live weekly from our bunker, safe below... where we're touched by any sort of fallout.
Very good. So what we'll do is let's try going right back to the video, Matt. I'll start it up again.
Ah.
Hi, guys. Welcome to the... My name is Joe King. The Vault Live. Vault would like to welcome a new sponsor. After 22 and a half, Tittman's been in the industry for nearly 30 years. The two of them together give us over 20 years of pain. Yes, for men and the vault. You're bored to have pneumatics made in the USA. You guys have seen before, but some of you have 68 in bombs. The owner's manual. That's good tank. He knows that a Tittman's used on siphon. 40 round ammo. Out of the PMR motor lid to keep out dirt and debris when you're in the swamp. Men's special.
All right, so welcome back, guys. Sorry, we are having some technical difficulties with our videos this evening, so we're going to try getting back to that in a moment. In the meantime, Chris, we might hit up some questions shortly.
Perfect.
As well as keep us posted on our Twitter feed.
And I always have tidbits.
We always have some tidbits, as well as we still have to talk about tonight's topic. So why don't we go up with a question first, Chris, and then we'll see if we can figure this out.
Okay, let's see here.
Oh, there we go.
That would be you, Chris.
Do you need
Brian Taylor. Sorry, there's no desk lamp here. It's very dimly lit.
Why don't you get a headlamp like a camper or...
Do you want us to call a whambulance?
All right. I got it now. The level of respect that used to exist not only between players and teams, but between fields. It seems like that has changed tremendously. What do you guys think? Asks Brian Taylor.
Guys?
I think it's still the same. I mean, there's always going to be people who cooperate with each other and get along, and there's always going to be feminine hygiene products in the sport, right? It's just sort of the nature of the beast, right? I don't think it's changed in terms of increase in that or decrease. I think it's pretty consistent.
Yep.
I agree.
I guess I got the only opinion. Yes.
Well, I don't think...
At the same time, it depends a lot on yourself, too. You can't just say, oh, the attitude's changed the game. Well, that means your attitude has too, you know?
Your attitude's changed.
Yeah.
Yours.
Yeah. If you're not part of the solution, you're part of the problem, Gavin.
That's right.
You need to be a solution. You need to go out there, spread the positive image of paintball, get other people playing. That'll change everything around.
I like it.
Yeah. All right. Keep them coming, Chris. We need another question.
Excellent. Well, actually, you know, these aren't really questions. I have the wrong stack. This is more opinions on the topic of the night.
You got the statement pages.
Thank you, Matt. However, I will just make one comment because Brandon Caudill again writes in, I miss seeing the huge popularity that once existed with local amateur leagues. The competition was great, but the camaraderie was even better. Average guys came out, formed teams, and appreciated the game for what it's worth. You just don't see this anymore.
Because people stopped showing up.
I agree. I think, I don't know, things have changed over the last few years, and maybe it's because Speedball's become more televised, as I mentioned before, on Paintball Access. You can see it. Maybe it's something that people are striving towards. But back five, 10 years ago, paintball for speedball was competitive, but it didn't have the egos that it did today because you weren't aspiring to do anything but win local tournaments. And I think the egos are getting bigger now that people can see them moving up the chain.
No, they want to be the big boys. The egos are getting smaller.
Yes, they are, and they're having internal LPRs, too.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. See what I did there?
Well, I have a question now rather than an opinion.
Is this your personal question or something?
It's not, actually. Kevin Erickson sends this one, and he says, I myself invite all players of all kinds to a scenario or big game event, but does it affect you or the game when you have mill sim, speedball, walk-ons, etc., when all in the mix?
For a big game, a scenario game, I'd say no. I think it's... I mean, there's still a lot of paint, a lot of people on the field on a regular rec ball day. I would say yes.
Yeah, it's like the T-shirts say. Some camp does not play well with others. Everyone, the speedball player is a definite, plays a little bit differently than a scenario player plays differently than a recreational player. If you can get everyone to sort of check their mindset at the door and go onto the field, then everyone would be fine. But you've got birthday kids and first timers all playing, and the speedball player. A lot of players don't have an off and on switch. It goes back to that, you want to encourage new players to get in the game and stay in the game and not get shot up.
Yeah. I have a theory, though. I think when you're playing a big gamer scenario, whether you have a rental person who's the first time out versus speedball guy or versus scenario team that are very aggressive, I think once the game gets underway, it all balances out, because what you'll find is the guys that are super aggressive will go charge, lead the way, and they'll balance out against the guys that are super aggressive on the other team. The guys that want to stay back, long ball, and take their time, they're always going to fight each other across those long fields. I mean, not always, but it does balance itself out.
And I think we are talking about, were we talking about scenario play or recreational everyday play? I may have missed the proverbial boat.
And I wasn't paying attention. What was the question?
The original question. Why don't we move on to another question?
Oh, it's
then.
Too long. Let's go to the next one.
I hate you guys.
Isn't social media supposed to be now?
If you guys would stop talking about these questions, we can look at the newspaper.
Hey
guys, what's your thoughts on the 5 pro teams that are left in the NPPL and are only playing the PSP? This one comes from Mike Green.
All right, what there, color? Joe. He's going to sort of shut you guys up. Chris, there's also a question about a Tippmann I want to get to.
Okay.
Well, let's answer the question. What about the 5 pro teams?
Well, there is only 5 pro teams left in the NPPL right now, as far as I know.
Who are they?
He's probably correct. I don't. I know a lot of teams are, not a lot, but there are a few teams that have left the NPPL and are strictly playing PSP due to the fact that they have sponsorship by certain paint companies, and certain paint companies are only allowed to be shot at PSP versus NPPL. So my personal thoughts, until all the paint companies get along and can all join up, it is, unfortunately, and I've heard from both sides of the gamut, and I don't know. I see both sides' points, and I understand there is not a resolution again this year, and I kind of understand why from both standpoints, but they got to find something, because this is killing it for everybody.
Two leagues enter, one league leaves.
But I think you need both leagues. I think you need the NPPL. I think it has a certain type of paintball. It's for a certain type of player, and X-ball as well. I think you need those two different formats, and they're night and day. It's not the difference between mag fed and hopper fed, because they're but it is a difference, but.
That's a good point. Thanks.
Yeah, Chris.
All right, you wanted a Tippmann question.
Okay, Joe, this is all you.
Which Tippmann question do you want? Because there's 4 of them.
Okay, go.
Well, which Tippmann were you looking for?
Just read one.
The middle one.
Okay,
let's go with
the one that has the image attached to it.
The one you can read because there's no light.
The one that has the image attached to it.
There's an image attached to it.
Would you just read one?
Do you want my glasses?
Okay. Make it up. Nobody's going to know if you just pick one.
This one comes from Eric Osman. The Tippmann A5 has been one of the most reliable scenario markers on the market, and there has been some improvements over the last couple of years. However, in my own opinion, I think Tippmann can make 2 improvements that would make this gun so much better. It may reinvent the wheel a tiny bit. However, what it comes down to is the mold for the A5 frame. For scenario players, we all love Weaver rails.
I think that Tippmann, when they designed the A5, it was modeled after the HK MP series, which that's the look. An MP series doesn't have any Picatinny rails or anything. They've since come out with a 416, which has some Picatinny rails and so on and so forth on it. I think that's where they've got away from. A couple companies in the early stages had a Picatinny rail mount. Special Ops had a Picatinny mount you could put underneath, remove the grip, and then you could put different mounts with Picatinny rails. And Tippmann at one point did sell a flat top Picatinny rail, which is an aftermarket piece. I don't think you'll see Tippmann do that. They may have a Picatinny. That's something that he should send to our friends at Tippmann, because they would be very receptive of that. if he would like to send me an email to store@flagraiders.com, attention Joe, I will forward that off to my friends at Tippmann Pneumatics and say that this was a suggestion from one of our viewers on the show.
I read that.
Or question. Eric Engler will do it for you.
Yeah.
Now, Matt, in the chat or in the production booth, I'm going to send you an audio signal through the mixer. Can you try and find it? And then we might be able to bring us back audio. In the meantime,
use your
Matt,
audio ears.
Can we just go back to this video real quick and see if how the sound turns out?
My name is Joe Kim. I would like to welcome brand new after.
Okay, so Matt, that didn't work. So I'm going to send you.
I don't really talk like that.
I'm going to send you an input, and you have to find it. It's on the mixer.
If you talk like that in the store, you'd never get anything sold.
I wouldn't. But
I would you like a quick tidbit to fill the?
Let's do a quick tidbit, and then we'll come back, and hopefully the audio issue will be fixed.
Yeah, let's tidbit you to death.
This is a tidbit that's close to home. Flag Raiders Paintball of Kitchener, Ontario, is proud to announce that their app is now live in the Apple App Store. To keep up to date on paintball events, tweets, news, and field and store locations and hours, head on over to the App Store and search for Flag Raiders to download the app today. Congratulations, Flag Raiders Paintball.
Do it now.
Awesome. Do it.
Very nice.
One of the few paintball apps that isn't an actual paintball game in the App Store when I was looking for it.
Well, thank
you
very much, Chris. That is, you know what? That is a kick-ass tidbit.
So, thank you.
I think I'm going to download it.
The topic tonight, guys, is what is one thing in paintball that has changed over the last few years that you've missed?
Are you asking us?
I am, actually. I'm going to give you guys an opportunity to speak up, and why don't we start with Gavin
I'm ready if Gavin's going to stumble.
I'm ready. You know what? Just leave me alone. Just a bully-free zone. I'm going to say what I miss most about the those were the days. The old days. Would have to be the battery-free mech markers. I like the slower pace play, pump markers, stock class markers, any of the mech guns versus the 30 balls a second, I can shoot as much paint at you as humanly possible.
So 30 misses a second.
Yeah, I think I miss that style of play, so that's what I miss most. And I will stretch it out.
No, it's good.
I want to interrupt him.
I'm strong. I'm bigger than that.
Okay.
Don't be a behind a bunker bully. Okay. I want to have, I think that I miss the larger bore paintball. I've got some Sheridans that I would like to use at my house. I've got some KP2s and KP3s and PMI1s and Piranhas and 68 Magnums I want to use, and I can't because the balls are too big, too small, and they roll out the end. It's like polka paint. Roll out the barrel. It's great for Oktoberfest, but it's no good for everyday recreational paintball. I miss California Magnum.
Oh, that sounded expensive.
California Magnum?
That's paintball. It's from the vault, Josh. Before you were born, we were using California Magnum.
Once upon a time in the world of paintball.
When there was only black and white paintballs and there was no color. Long before we even knew what an iPhone app would be.
And the marker was only this big, right? And you had to sit 3 inches away from it.
It was made out of brass, my friend.
It was paintball blowpipes.
Yes. Can you tell us what you missed?
That's disturbing. What I'm gonna go with what Gavin said. I miss that.
No,
but I'm gonna change the words. Okay. I miss the methodical play behind people.
Special.
I miss that. It's just too much spray that way, and then we're just
and pray.
Gonna try and pray, and then we hit somebody else.
Spray and pray.
I also miss the fact that people used to just go and play paintball. Now it's like, I gotta get a mag fed marker, I gotta get a pump, or I gotta get this, I gotta get that. It's like just
what camo are you gonna wear?
Go out in the field.
Do these boots look good?
And then I'm gonna just make a point. I drew a tube of first strike rounds right here on my sheet today.
That's nice.
It's $7.99 per tube, and you get 8 rounds in there. Many people are switching to mag fed in order to save money while you play. That's $1 a round, people. You can't use the economy as an excuse when you're playing with first
party. Yeah, it's on a smartboard. It's a piece of paper, and the camera's not picking it up.
I'm going to change subjects here for guys. I'm going to try another video, and let's see how this audio works. Okay.
Are you going to play my video?
Then we're going to try going back. Ready? Okay, come back. Okay, so one sec. Matt, you should be on line input from through him. Mute the TV and we'll try it again. Okay, I'm going to go back and try and play the vault.
Hi guys, welcome back to
check
the
that out.
Okay, so either way,
turn all the mics down, Matt.
They don't pay.
So after 22 and a half years, Tippmann's been in the industry, Flagler's been in the industry for nearly 30 years. The two coming together give us over 50 years of paintball goodness. And just to show my commemorativeness for Tippmann and the Vault welcoming you aboard, I have Tippmann Pneumatics, Fort Wayne, Indiana, made in the USA. You guys have seen this before, but some of you haven't. 68 special in box. Here's the owner's manual. 7-ounce siphon tube tank, because everybody knows that Tippmann's used to run better on siphon. 40-round ammo box. This one's been slightly modified with a PMI loader lid to keep out dirt and debris when you're foraging through the swamp with the early Tippmann's. 68 special. Lock and load. Safety wasn't actually, this one actually doesn't have a safety. Some of the later models actually you pull back and it would pull up and you'd have a safety. This one is number 8943. These came with a little sling. Guys, remember shooting these, it'd be blowback, there'd be smoke and steam coming out. Awesome. So that's 68 special. Next week, I think maybe we will look at the Tippmann 20th anniversary, 2086 to 2006, 20th anniversary, limited edition commemorative marker. This one I'm not going to show you because the seal is not broken on the box, but we do have that one at the indoor that I will share with you, so we'll look for that for next week's vault. Anyway, guys, welcome Tippmann Pneumatics, Fort Wayne, Indiana. I'll see you guys next week on From the Vault. My name's Joe, and we'll see you.
Studio. All right, so very good. We have video back. Hooray!
Good Joe!
Dustin, we need you back. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to move on.
I don't think it's Dustin.
Here is a video. We're going to move into a couple things right away. Skeletor sent this in. Now, Skeletor took over the booth that we had at Paintball Extravaganza this year. If you didn't know,
take it
we
over.
Were there.
He was left in charge.
Well, let's let the video show this. Matt, let's head on over.
I should go check on Skeletor.
Skeletor, what the hell's going on?
Well, things got a little carried away.
Everything got carried away. The whole show's taken apart. Man.
I'll get to the bottom of this. Check the security tape.
We'll be right back.
awesome.
Very
Skeletor.
Good.
Nice. Skeletor.
Very good. Skeletor. It was nice to see that he got kicked out. So, so very good. So we're going to move on, guys. Tonight's topic, as we've been talking about, is what is the one thing in paintball that's changed over the past few years that, well, that you don't like? Why don't we move over and check out Joker from North Carolina.
We've got C-ball, mill-sand, wood-ball, mag-band, all these different styles of play. And then taking the sport of paintball that was never thought imaginable when I started playing. Now, with that being said, it's also created what, in my opinion, is a problem in paintball. And that's that we're no longer a group of paintball players when we hit the field. We're either a C-baller, or a wood-baller, or a mag-band guy. This is not good for the sport. Every time I hit the field, I hear a C-baller say that their style of play is better. All about a wood-baller saying that speedball guns look like alien guns, but that their jerseys look dumb. Look, I'm a dedicated Nielsen player, but I'll be the first to tell you that speedball jerseys not only look awesome, they're comfortable to wear, and actually watching speedball, it's awesome, whether it's on the internet or in person. It's an awesome style of paintball to watch. Even though I can't play, I still enjoy watching it. If we can get rid of all the divisions in paintball, if we can get rid of that tag of speedballer or mag band guy, if we can get rid of that, and we were just a group of paintballers in the field, we could probably even take over the world. I'm going to get started on this spot in the world. Take over and stuff. You guys take it easy.
All right.
Jesus Christ.
Well done. All right. So, guys, if you would like to be a part of this abomination that we call a paintball show, head on over to... show at behindthebunker.com, and you can send us general questions, your team bios, your custom gear picks, event posters, or nominate a player of the week. So we're going to move on, guys. We have another video to get to. This one here is from J-Hub telling us her thoughts on what she misses in paintball.
She's got her hair did.
Disrespecting people out there. Let's not do that anymore. Have a great night. Bye.
Yeah. So, folks, if you like what you've seen here this evening, only this evening, you can certainly help us out by purchasing a support package. We have a couple available for you, which includes a t-shirt, barrel bag, some stickers. And if you want to get swag-tastic, ladies and gentlemen, go with the Deluxe Support Package, which includes a t-shirt, stickers, barrel sock, and the 3D patch. All of this wonderful stuff for $44.99, and that keeps us on the air, videos working, audio, everything synced, all of that wonderful stuff.
Kitchen sink?
Kitchen sink.
And you know that we're flogging because we need some...
Limited time!
This here, guys. This is Portraits from our 100th show. Autographed and signed for all the people on the cast.
Are they numbered? Do you get a certificate of authenticity as well? Oh. Todd's going to make those now.
No, they're going to be written on the back.
Certificate of authenticity.
Authentic. It'll be written on the
back.
And folks, you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel. And you can catch all the Behind the Bunker past episodes as well as other shenanigans that are on the go. Future ones, you'll have to wait till you see it live and then it's uploaded afterwards. So catch the past episodes. And you can also communicate with our friend Chris Christopherson via Twitter at behindthebunker.com or behindthebunker on Twitter. That tweeting thing, whatever.
Gavin's given up social media for Lent.
My mind's all gone crazy.
He doesn't know. This is all socially overwhelming for him.
Socially overwhelming, yes.
Very good.
That stuff. Support packages.
Well, why don't we move on, guys? We have another video to get to. This is from a new correspondent, first time this week. So bear with it. This is from PChem.
What?
Pekin here with Kansas State Paintball. This week's question is, what is one thing you miss about paintball that has seemed to change in the last few years? I've been playing paintball for 6 years now, and I've seen a couple things come and go. The main thing that I do miss about paintball is players who move. I've seen the sport slowly transition to those guns that can really pump out the balls per second, and the players have tended to shift towards that style of play where you kind of sit in the back and let your paint fly. I really miss that style of play that makes players move, that, you know, gets them on the front line, and a lot of those, that style of play is associated with those players who don't shoot, you know, 20 balls a second. I miss that style of play back in the day where the guns didn't shoot that fast and it forced players to move. That's the one thing that I miss most, and I feel has changed the most over the course of the paintball in the past few years. That's just my 2 cents. I'm signing off. You're watching Behind the Bunker.
Well thought, well thought out, very well done. We'll hopefully see more from him over the next few months. And again, the next week's topic is...
What is next week's topic?
What is the next week's topic? Does anyone remember?
It's probably on the sheet you gave me earlier today.
It is. What Hold makes on. A good field good?
Oh, that's a good one.
Goodness.
Very interesting. All right, we're going to keep moving forward, guys. We still have lots of videos to get to. We are going to head on over to a new correspondent all the way from Portugal. This is Carla. She is part of the Girl Paintballer franchise. So let's have a listen here.
Hello, Behind the Bunker. I am Carla from Portugal, one of the new members of the Girl Paintballer team. So, the topic for this week's show is, what is the most thing you missed about paintball that has seemed to change in the past few years? Okay, so let's see. Paintball, as we know it, has evolved considerably in the past few years. Nowadays, I think that paintball has evolved positively, but we still have lots of hard work to do. If you ask me what I miss about paintball, I will have to say nothing. I really don't miss nothing, because I truly believe that paintball is much better now than it was a few years ago. So let's see, we have lots of new players, girl players, which is awesome. General conditions to play have improved to highest level, and you now have the chance to play in places you have never dreamed of. There are more brands, and consequently we have more to choose. The prices are better now due to existing a lot of paintball suppliers. Another thing that is better now, for example, if you have a problem with your marker or whatsoever, it's not difficult to find help. And I will give you an example. My boyfriend, about 8-9 years ago, bought an intimidator, a Bob Long intimidator, and he had a hard time trying to find help with the settings and other problems. Nowadays, you have tech supports that can help you with any marker you choose to buy, which is very good, actually. Another thing, the marketing and publicity around events is also better, and it's getting the attention of more paintball players. The quality of the game and the quality of the players is much higher now. So, as you can see, in the end, I truly believe that paintball is much better now than a few years ago. So I really don't miss anything. Well, maybe one thing, I was much younger back then than I am now, but that's life. And that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you soon.
Watching Girl Paintball, Bobby's Boys not apply, baby.
You're watching Girl Paintball and Mama's Boys be not apply.
and I'm Josh at Zubies of Arkansas, bringing you lots of events for paintball around the world.
Paintball Around the World is brought to you by Vulcan. Welcome to Paintball Around the World. Ooh. If you have a poster you'd like to add into Paintball Around the World, send it to show@behindthebunker.com and we'll be sure to add it in for next week. So, hopefully, we got posters. Beautiful. And they're completely out of order.
That's okay. 2013 Generals.
Are you sure?
2013 Generals.
Oh, no, there's Embrace the Battle.
Embrace the posters.
Embrace the poster. Look, and then all the sponsors, too. Perfect. Awesome. April 13th and 14th.
Great.
And the Brotherhood Tour coming to a field near you. ODST and guests, Sonny Lopez, Greg Hastings, Patrick Boulanger, and many more.
Awesome.
And the Super Duper Game 45. I know that Clint, 300 FPS, will be there for sure. It's happening May 3rd through till 5th, and I believe maybe...
Maybe
Todd's going to be there with his little ding-a-ling-a-ling bell. And next up, Fight for Asylum, where, yes, I will be in maybe Todd. Yeah.
As you can see, there's a trend here. I don't like to tell people I'm leaving until...
And the one and only Colonel Mustard.
Nice.
Yeah.
Gavin won't be going because he's allergic to mustard.
Not unless I'm an EpiPen.
Yeah.
Speaking of EpiPens.
And here's the new Fight for Asylum Media Partners poster. Check out that right smack dab in the middle. Lime green behind the bunker. Fantastic.
It is pretty cool.
And Extreme Paintball Guns for Hoses May 5th. And is the best behind the bunker cameo sticker ever. And Canadian Carnage 2013 is happening June 15th at the Flag Raiders Paintball in Kitchener, Ontario. Join Bob Noxious or Mike Phelps.
He's a swimmer.
I'm sorry.
The swimmer's
stopped. He's going to bring his gold medals.
I was being distracted by Joe, who keeps pointing at something.
In your defense, Spudson on Twitter just put it as Mike Phelps. So.
Spudson, yeah. All right. No, so that's what I was reading. Very good. Good job, Spudson. Throw the whole show right off. And Black Hawk Down is coming. The Mogadishu Mile, September 22nd. Happening at Flag Raiders Field. Check out the partners across the bottom on the bottom. It's fantastic. And behind the bunker. And, yeah, okay.
It's grid production.
ODX's Top Sniper, the inaugural paintball competition, is happening on April 7th.
Yeah!
What the heck was that?
That's my jihad shit. Oh.
Let's do something for D-Day, Joe. D-Day, yeah. Guns of Navarone. Join Gavin and myself as we battle out for supremacy of the Flag Raiders Field on May 26th. Gavin, maybe this year you might want to think about packing a little bit of fight when you show up in the morning. Yeah? Thanks, buddy. Let's all come together. Stargate, September 14th and 15th. Put on by Shoreline Paintball.
This from the guy who tobogganed on my air-ups bunker for most of the afternoon of his last game he generaled.
That was just entirely too much fun. Landing Zone Paintball Invasion of Normandy is happening April 18th and 19th in Columbiaville, Michigan. Check out the Behind the Bunker logo on there. Limited edition gold.
Nice.
South Park, A Town Divided is happening April 28th. Sign up with Cartman's Side and fight those hippies.
Hippies?
Hippies are actually deathly afraid of death metal, in case you ever need to know. Red Dawn Occupation Part 2 is happening April 20th and 21st, and that's the D-Day field. Mm. Battlefield Rush is happening June 19th, 201. Might be a little bit late for this game.
The Romans.
But that's all right. Yeah, the Romans will probably be participating in that one. Alien versus Predator versus Marines, April 26th through till 28th, the LCP scenario games. Check out that fantastic Behind the Bunker logo. And Animal Bunker Fest, May 18th and 19th, to take place at San Antonio, Texas.
Dem's got good chili.
And Port Huron is hosting their Big Game 11. I believe last year they had the world's greatest chili, but apparently not this year. Sadly disappointing. To think, I was gonna go.
I hope you're not driving home afterwards.
Chaos Blast Camp 25th anniversary. Hopefully, Chris won't interrupt the segment anymore because he's got his own now, even though it's too long and it's just tidbits. April 20th and 21st.
Wow, which one's Zuby's mic back here?
Oh, you can feel the love tonight.
It's awesome. I said it before, I'll say it again. You shut your mouth when you talk over my segment. Vulcan Cup is here, finally. It's 2013. Stay tuned for more details.
I have a tidbit for that one.
Raiders Cup. The next event is happening March 24th at the indoor location in Kitchener, Ontario. And yes, it finally had the Beyond the Bunker logo on.
Nice.
Then Living Legend 6 is May 17th through till 19th at CPX Field. And I believe Todd and Joe will be there representing Behind the Bunker. You win your own special little spot in the VIP booth.
Where's that?
CPX.
Oh.
And Field of Mystic Fire, April 7th, is hosting their Sox versus Yanks game. And not only that, hold the phone. Two Behind the Bunker logos.
Awesome.
That's scary. Wow.
Super duper. You got the left and what's the right. This? And this is the poster that Chris stole earlier in the evening. This is the MagFed Rap 4 Siege of Bastion, which is going
to
be happening on
I'm
the Oklahoma
click,
D-Day.
But the link is not working.
On June 13th.
I click here, but it's not working.
Don't click. Don't click.
Click hard, Gavin.
Click hard, boy.
And just announced the March Meltdown is going on at EMR. This will be March 23rd and 24th. Yes, Joe.
Nothing.
Who are you pointing at?
I wasn't.
You're excitedly pointing at the poster. I thought maybe you saw something that was cool.
No.
So why don't we move on? Josh, what do they need to do if they want to get a poster on the air?
We send it to show@behindthebunker.com. Definitely not my Facebook page.
So guys, we're going to move on. We still have a couple more videos to get to from Tech and Chase Traffic Morris. Why don't we get to those right now, and we'll be right back.
What's up, guys? Welcome back to Behind the Bunker. This week's question, what is one thing that you miss that has seemed to change about paintball in the last few years? I'm more of a new player, to be honest. I've only been playing for a couple of years, so not much has seemed to change for me. The main thing, though, that I miss from just what I've seen from paintball past would just kind of have to be the old style of pump markers. Like, just the original markers, Splatmasters, things like that. That's something that I really want to get my hands on and just play a couple games with. It looks really fun. It's something that definitely has changed and just evolved through the years into all the markers we have now. But it's something that I really personally would love to get my hands on and shoot. Thanks for watching Behind the Bunker.
How's it going, guys? It's Traffic with the Trap Cam. You're watching Behind the Bunker. And this week's question is, what's the one thing in paintball that you miss that seemed to change over the past few years? For me, it'd have to be scenario roleplay. Usually for 26-hour games, I would be a role player. But
hey, how's it going, guys? This is Traffic Jam from the Traffic Cam. Let's get to this.
Chase is great.
We're having technical difficulties.
I like his song.
He actually doesn't grumble when he sings, but it's no, the way I hear it in my ears. I have to be honest with you, that is one of my favorite songs so far. And if you out there...
It's also the way you walk around the studio singing it.
Behind the Bunker.
It's great.
You know how fighters have certain music and stuff they do to do before fights? Well, we play that song on a loop before we go to shows. That's sometimes why we're so feisty, I think.
In the DTV dressing room.
The green room.
Very good. So, guys, thank you for bearing with us tonight. We have We had a lot of technical issues tonight that we are going to hopefully fix next week. We still have a couple tidbits that we have to get to. Chris, what do you have in the tidbittery?
In the tidbittery, I have an announcement from FogDoc.com. Derek Roberts of FogDoc announced today that FogDoc has signed on as a gold sponsor of Super Game 45. The company, famous in the industry for their advanced lens cleaning and anti-fog technology, will have a booth in Vendor Village May 3rd through the 5th, 2013. FogDoc will be offering special pricing on products as well as free lens cleaning to all players and referees during the event. Sponsors like FogDoc are expected to donate over $25,000 in prizes for the Super Game 45 raffle, with proceeds being donated to Team Challenge Oregon.
Very good.
Yeah. Huh.
Yeah. God, is that infectious or what? Is that all for your tidbittery tonight?
Well, I did have something about the Vulcan Cup, but Zuby did a pretty good job about announcing it. All right.
So, guys, I want to say thank you very much for putting up with our technical glitches tonight. We are going to have them fixed for next week now that we know what it is. And we will see you guys back here. So I want to say thank you to all the guys in the panel. Zuby, do you have anything you want to say? Put you on the spot.
Yeah, if you
he also dubs as Isaac on the Love Boat, by the way.
Send your posters into showitbehindthebunker.com. Send by the Facebook page. Grab the logo, throw it on your poster. Again, send it to show@behindthebunker.com. Just send it in. Please, please don't send it to me on Facebook.
Thank Screen cap.
Oh, wow.
Very good.
Look like a puppy dog bull master. Anyway, guys, for Custom Corner, anything you've modified, tricked out, customized in your paintball gear, hi. Welcome to my segment.
I didn't have enough of my own screen time.
No, it's good. It's nice. It's great. Anything you've modified, customized, or tricked out in any way, shape, or form in your paintball gear, send it to us. Show it behind the bunker for Custom Corner. And if you have any shots of yourself playing paintball, send them to show it behind the bunker. Attention, action shots. And we'll get them in. Please make sure you're wearing your clothing, because those kind of action shots we don't want.
Speak for yourself, Joseph.
Well, Gavin, you want pictures of Walter Brennan naked, like in Good Morning Vietnam.
That's right. And folks, if there's anything bothering you about the sport of paintball that you want to get off your chest because it's grinding your gears, jamming your hopper, or rupturing your disc, send it to showupbehindthebunker.com, and we will discuss it here on What's Up With That.
Nice.
Yeah.
Chris.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's good. Go
sure.
Good one.
Steal half Gavin's segment.
Yo, original. We take one syllable words and make them 5 minutes long. Chris.
All right. So, guys, if you have anything that you would like the show to discuss or questions for question time, I am always watching social media. Hit us up on Twitter, Facebook, or feel free to send an email to show@behindthebunker.com with your tidbit, and we'll try and get it on air. Thanks very much.
See, hear that, guys? Isn't that creepy or what? Chris is always watching.
I'm always watching.
And he'll put
remember,
your
guys, if you have a paintball event, be sure to post that on Zuby's Facebook wall, just like he asked you to.
God damn it. Swear.
Now, guys, keep your eyes open. In the next few weeks, we have a special guest that will be coming up to our panel. Some of you may know him as, you know what, let's just tease it. We will see him on the panel
A
few weeks, maybe, or on your lap, rather.
Ooh.
Very nice. So, guys, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it. Sorry for the technical glitches tonight, but we will see you back next week with a fresh new show.
Fresh.
Matt, I'm going to play the intro out. And, guys, we will see you guys next week on Behind the Bunker.